First of all, can you introduce yourself? What role you play in the development?
Yeah, my name is Mordecai Bell. I work as a programmer at IO Interactive. I've been in Indonesia as both a gameplay programmer and wrapping up the PC version for release. And general purpose programming across all platforms.
So you've worked with the other platforms as well?
I have.
And has there been any more difficulty between coding one version to the other?
Well, I think as most developers will probably tell you, the PlayStation 3 can be a challenge to get started on. It's a very interesting platform. It's one that holds a lot of potential that's just waiting to be unlocked as we get to know it better. It's an attractive platform in many ways to work on, but it's also one that requires a bit of extra effort because it's so different from a lot of the other platforms.
So tell me about Hangman Lynch. How did it start?
Well, it's you might call it a spiritual successor to Freedom Fighters in the way that we're using squad-based gameplay and so on, but in many ways it's more its own game. We like to call it a heist movie or a buddy movie gone bad. It's probably a mix of the two. It's a third-person action shooter, and the two main characters, King and Lynch, you follow them through the entire game. You're in control of the character called King. It's a former mercenary. His problem is that his wife and daughter have been kidnapped by some people to get some back belonging to them. And Lynch is assigned to be his watchdog. Neither of them are very comfortable with that arrangement, but they're sort of forced into it by circumstances, and that's what we call it for the game.
Can you tell me what kind of levels there are? I saw one on the rooftop of the hardbox. Can you tell me about other levels?
Well, in general, as you progress through the game, the scope sort of expands. You start at the very bottom of the food chain. You have nothing except a prisoner suit and a gun, and you try to make do with what you have. Later on in the game, you start to do heists like bank robbery and so on to try to get what you've been tasked with getting. And at the end, it sort of expands into more of a military shooting almost, like we saw the level in Cuba with the helicopter, and lots of people to come here, and lots of more military style elements. So the scope of the game sort of changes a lot.
Roughly how long is the single player?
I would estimate that probably around 12 hours.
Can you quickly talk about multiplayer? I had a quick go at it and I really enjoyed it. There was only two levels on the try. Can you sort of expand on that, like other maps, other modes, if there are any?
Well, there's only one multiplayer mode in the game, and that's the one we call Fragile Alliance.
Right.
What we did there was take the heist of the single player campaign and look at what's going on with the heist, the getting to the loot, the disputes over how it should be divided, the sort of fragile bonds that keep people in this situation together, and see what kind of gameplay elements we could build up around that. And that's what turn into Fragile Alliance. You have every team member, every player starting in the same team in an alliance, trying to get to the loot, being forced to cooperate in order to actually get into the bank vault or get to the diamonds or whatever, trying to get away with it. But then as the loot has been reached and the pockets are full, then starts to become clear that maybe you don't want to share your money with all the other guys. So that's where the alliance starts to break, and it turns into more of a free-for-all, actually. You're free to fend for yourself and choose who to be an ally with, who to betray.
Is this like a one-off only game, or possibly be a sequel? I know, I don't, it's like you can tell me if they survive or whatever. But
there is a sequel plan,
right.
Which is in the early stages of the production.
Okay.
And Lionsgate has already bought the rights for the new adaptation, so we are hoping to turn it into a franchise.
Finally, what's next for the team? Is there any other projects you can talk about?
Well, a lot of people have moved on to have early looks at what should happen in Kingdom Hearts 2. We have some plans for downloadable content for Kingdom Hearts 1, which is also in development right now. And then we have some other very interesting projects that I can't tell you too much about, unfortunately.
Is this the end of Hitman?
I don't think we've seen the last of Hitman. There's a movie coming out, I think after the movie people are going to want to revisit some of that universe again. There's going to be it's probably going to be more Hitman, but it's also going to be different.
Okay. Thanks.
Thank you.